हेलो जनता, टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन। पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिएक्शन फॉर इनऑर्गेनिक सिंथेसिस, पर्टिकुलरली फॉर सीसी बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन। अदरवाइज इफ यू वांट टू स्किप सम इंटरमीडिएट स्टेप, सपोज इफ यू हैव वेन एवर देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इंटरमीडिएट, देन ऑलवेज देर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ फॉर्मिंग एन मल्टीपल प्रोडक्ट। सो इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड दिस वी आर यूजिंग पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन, बिकॉज इन दिस रिएक्शन देर आर नो इंटरमीडिएट्स। ओके, सो देर आर सेवरल एडवांटेजेस फॉर दिस रिएक्शंस। ओके, एज वेल एज फॉर नेट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू और एनी एंट्रेंस एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, गेट और नेट एग्जाम। तो फॉर पर्टिकुलरली फॉर नेट एग्जाम इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू कम अराउंड 15 to 20 मार्क्स वेटेज फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक। विदाउट ऑप्शन आई एम सेइंग, विद ऑप्शन इट इज इवन मोर देन दैट। ओके, सो टुडे वील बी डिस्कसिंग, दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन, वेर आई एम डिस्कसिंग यू अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन, वट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन। ओके, एंड सेकंड पार्ट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल्स एंड सिमेट्री, एंड फ्रॉम थर्ड पार्ट ऑनवर्ड्स वी विल स्टार्टिंग अवर इलेक्ट्रोसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन। ओके, सो फर्स्ट टू लेक्चर्स ऑफ दिस पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन सीरीज वी आर डिस्कसिंग ओनली ऑन द बेसिक्स ऑफ और बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द पेरिसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन। ओके, आफ्टर दैट वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग एक्चुअल रिएक्शन। ओके, सो इफ आई डायरेक्टली स्टार्ट इलेक्ट्रोसाइक्लिक रिएक्शन देन देर विल बी प्रॉब्लम। सो you want to get some feeling of pericyclic reaction, what is pericyclic reaction, for that you have to focus on this first two videos. Okay, so see, so what I have written here, there are several ways to classify reactions. So one way of classifying reaction is based on the intermediate form. Suppose if you have some ions like carbocation, carbon ion, then you will be dealing it in ionic reaction. Okay, if you have some radical, so you are classifying it as a radical kind of classification, and especially pericyclic reaction comes into picture now. So we know that in pericyclic reaction there are no intermediates. Okay, so whenever you have ionic intermediate or radical intermediate, so transition state of that reaction, it might be cyclic or acyclic. Okay, it can be both. It can be both possibilities are there. But whenever there is a possibility of, whenever we are discussing about a pericyclic reaction, always remember that there are no intermediates formed in this reaction, and the transition state is always cyclic. Okay. Now, what is meant by pericyclic? If you Google it, is the meaning of this pericyclic reaction, then it means the around the circle. Around the circle means pericyclic reaction. Okay, so for definition purpose in for chemistry, organic chemistry point of view, what we are defined it, how we are defining it, reaction that occur by cyclic shift of electron via cyclic geometry of transition state means. Transition state is should be like this, cyclic shifting of electron circle. Okay, so in any pericyclic reaction you will get this cyclic transition state. Okay, and electron is revolving in cyclic way, cyclic loop of electron we can say. Okay, so who are the pioneers of this pericyclic reaction? See, actual pericyclic reaction were discovered were studied by Woodward, Hoffman and Fukui. These three are pioneer scientist. Okay, so for their study, Hoffman and Fukui already got this Nobel Prize for studying pericyclic reaction, classifying them pericyclic reaction. Okay, and how to predict the product, on that basis they already got Nobel Prizes. Woodward also have a significant contribution in pericyclic reaction, but he doesn't got a Nobel Prize because he already awarded Nobel Prize in 1965 for its natural product synthesis, like you know that Reserpine synthesis, 23 step synthesis, and there are so many synthesis are there, juvenile hormone synthesis. So he is very renowned chemist for. Okay, now top of that, now you will be thinking pericyclic reaction is older than is very old, like if you consider that Diels-Alder reaction got Nobel Prize in 1950. Okay, but there are not a systematic classification or systematic theory available to understand that. But these three people have done systematic study and classify them. Okay, so only their approach is to classify them, how to predict them product, like that they have classified and studied well using molecular orbital theory. Now we'll be discussing about characteristic of pericyclic reaction. Okay, the first characteristic we are discussing, it's a concerted mechanism. Okay, what is meant by concerted? Bond making and breaking takes place simultaneously, both at the same time. Okay, then second state, second characteristic we are discussing about transition state. So in pericyclic reaction, geometry is always cyclic of this transition state, and reaction involve ring of electron move in a cyclic loop. Already I told you that electron will move like this. Suppose if it is chair form, it will move like this electron, cyclic shift of electron in chair form. Cyclic is important. Okay, if you are discussing about solvent, so does this see what you know that if you are having an intermediate like ionic intermediate carbocation carbonate, then there is a role of solvent. But here in pericyclic reaction, the transition state having very partial charge, very less charge is there, partial charge. So solvent doesn't play any role here in determining the rate of reaction. Okay, the polarity of the solvent does not play any great impact on the rate of the yield of the reaction because it's having a partial charge. Okay, then we move into the catalyst. Okay, so does catalyst having a role? So in broad sense we can say catalyst doesn't have an effect on pericyclic reaction, but it's a debatable, but there are some debatable exceptions are there, like if you, there are some sigmatropic reactions are there which are catalyzed by catalyst, or some you already know that Diels-Alder reaction where we use Lewis acid catalyst like AlCl3, SbCl5, like that catalyst we are using in Diels-Alder reaction for this, what this catalyst get combined with the dienophile and it will decrease the energy, decrease the LUMO. Okay, so there are the more decrease the activation energy and more interaction as there. So there are some exceptions are there. So directly we cannot say that catalyst, but overall in majority of the reaction catalysts have no role in pericyclic reaction, that we can say. Okay, so now we'll discuss about the reaction intermediate. So do not reaction intermediate is not there, do not follow ionic or radical pathway, so there is no question of reaction intermediate and hence unaffected by acid base or radical initiator or inhibitor. Okay, but guys, there are some reactions which are actually, suppose some reactions are there which are thermally forbidden on the basis of pericyclic reaction, okay, or pericyclic reaction theory you can say, but still that reactions are possible at high temperature. So once I am saying it is a high temperature, okay, so that means it can be follow non-concerted mechanism. So if it following non-concerted mechanism, then obviously it will follow radical or ionic pathway. Always remember that. Okay, when I am discussing actual examples of electrocyclic reaction, that time I will cover that topic. Okay, so still so no need to discuss now that topic. But suppose if you are getting product and at high temperature, but orbital point of view, if you are not able to understand that, always remember that it will follow radical pathway or ionic pathway, not pericyclic pathway. And once I am saying it's a radical or ionic pathway, that means it will follow non-concerted pathway. Okay, then if we focus on stereochemistry, okay, stereochemistry directly I am taking example. So see, if I am having a substrate, if I heated it, suppose if I am getting cis product, okay, then same substrate on giving light energy, I am getting trans product. So pericyclic reactions are stereospecific with respect to energy provided. If I provide it heat, I am getting cis or meso compound. If I am giving it light, I am getting trans or enantiomer. It is general I am saying. If I am supplying light energy, I am getting trans or enantiomer compound. Okay, so you can read this theory. Pericyclic reaction can be stereospecific with respect to energy provided. Same substance can give different stereochemical product. Depends on activation energy supplied to reactant molecule either in the form of heat or light. Okay, so why this is happening? Okay, so in order to understand this feature, we need to understand we need to go into more deeper into the molecular orbital theory. Okay, so as you can see, I have taken here two orbitals, psi 1, psi 2. I have named psi 1 and psi 2, or you can say ground state singlet or excited state singlet, you can say. Okay, so if I am supplying here thermal energy, then whatever excitation will take place, not that will take place at vibrational level. You know that there are three levels. Suppose if we have this, electronic state, okay, S0. So here you have vibrational level. Okay, in between this vibrational, rotational levels are also there, rotational energy levels. Okay, so I am telling you about the vibrational level. So whenever you heat the reaction, if you provide thermal energy, then there is a vibrationally excited ground state will take place. Okay, so but for same molecule, if you supply light energy, then what happened? One electron will shift to higher orbital without changing its spin, Okay, so this we are saying at photochemical excitation in electronically excited state. So now changes in take place in electronic level, not in vibrational level. Electron jump to higher energy orbital. Okay, but here it is not like that. Here it is in vibrationally excited ground state only. Okay, so this is the major difference. So now you will be telling me, now you will be thinking about what is the difference, that is still it is excitation only. But guys, remember that orbital symmetry is changing. Psi 1 and Psi 2 cannot have the same geometry, same symmetry. Like if you are having a mirror symmetry, if it will having a mirror asymmetry. So what is mirror symmetry, what is mirror asymmetry or Psi 2 symmetry, that we will go into later part of this topic, in second part of this topic. So only remember that there is a changing in the bonding and anti-bonding level symmetry. That's why you are getting changing in the product symmetry. So directly you can mug up that substrate will give cis and trans, but main what is the background of that? Background is excitation. Suppose if you are in photochemistry, sometime what happened, excitation will take place, intersystem crossing will take place from singlet to triplet by changing this spin. So we are changing a triplet. So in photochemistry we are using such reaction. Suppose if you have a benzophenone, so benzophenone having a high high probability of giving a triplet, okay, it will form, it will allow to, it will allow us to give us intersystem crossing. So in majority of the photochemistry reaction we are using benzophenone as a triplet photosensitizer, okay, but this part is not coming under paracyclic reaction. This we will discuss in photochemistry, but this is the main background of that different products. Okay, now we will be discussing classification of paracyclic reaction. So classification of paracyclic reaction is again done by that Woodward, Hoffman. Okay, how they have done, they have analyzed the chemical behavior of paracyclic reaction and they found application of MOT. According to MOT, they have classes this reaction according to cycloaddition, electrocyclic, sigmatropic, group transfer reaction. Okay, in modern theory you can find some more classification like cheletropic elimination or cheletropic addition. So that all are part of the reaction, but actual classification of paracyclic reaction is based on four methods. Okay, now what are the theories for understanding this paracyclic reaction? So first theory is developed by Hoffman and Fukui, that is known as frontier molecular orbital theory. And you know what is meant by FMO? FMO means homolumo concept, which we are using for discussion. Orbital correlation diagram is again discussed by Hoffman and Woodward. So this theory is basically based on the diagram, but this theory is basically used for our subjective exam, like in your university exam, orbital correlation diagram, where you have to draw the reactant and product orbital diagram and you have to correlate that. Okay, so this part in NET or GATE exam is never asked such question. So this is the purely university based question in theory part. Then third theory is based on the perturbational molecular orbital theory. Okay, perturbational molecular orbital theory is based on basically whether that transition state is aromatic or anti-aromatic, based on that is feasible or not feasible. Okay, this based on purely on transition state of aromatic or anti-aromatic. This we will be dealing with separate topic for this discussion. Okay, so in future also, in next videos also, whatever we are discussing about is that we discuss about the FMO and perturbation molecular orbital theory, and that from these three we will discussing about the Woodward Hoffman rule, that shortcut rule. Okay, so see, in the first part what we have discussed, about the definition of paracyclic reaction, then what are the characteristics of paracyclic reaction, then which are the theories available for paracyclic reaction, then classification of paracyclic reaction. Okay, this part we have done yet. These are very basic topic. Okay, only I need to give you background. Okay, in my second video we will be discussing about the molecular orbitals and symmetry properties. Thank you.